Good morning, dear students of class 8. Today, I am again here to teach you history. As you all know that just because of outbreak of COVID-19 and complete lockdown, DPS Dhaka has organized online classes for you so that you can continue your study without any obstacles. My dear students, in previous classes, we read about modernization of world history. What was the period of modernization in India? What was the main changes that took places in modern India? What were the features of modernization? We already read about this. Today, we will read about the main forces, the main regions which are responsible for modernization. My dear students, the main forces of change or the main regions that are responsible for modernization are, the very first one is the Renaissance. The second one is the Industrial Revolution. The third one is the American and French Revolution. The fourth one is nationalism. My dear students, these all forces of changes began in Europe and then it spread across all over the world. So let us have a brief glance on each forces, on each regions briefly. The very first is the Renaissance. My dear students, the Renaissance was a movement which was started in Italy in 14th century. Again, listen carefully. The Renaissance was a movement that started in Italy in 14th century. The Renaissance means rebirth. Again, listen carefully. The Renaissance means rebirth. Basically, Renaissance gave rise to scientifically method of questioning, scientifically method of observation, that is learning by questioning, that is learning by observation, that is learning by experimentation. People were unwilling to accept anything that was without any logic, that was without any clue. Now people started thinking logically, people started thinking rationally, and people started asking questions about old traditions and superstitions. So this was all about Renaissance. Now the second reason for modernization was the Industrial Revolution. My dear students, the Industrial Revolution was an economic revolution. It was started in Britain in 1715. At this time, the population of European countries were increasing rapidly. In this situation, the demand of goods increased dramatically, and it changed the system of artisans who worked at their home with their simple tools, with machineries and factories. These machineries and factories started producing the same goods in very fast and very fraction of cost, means very cheap, and in very less time they started producing the same goods which were produced by the traditional artisans. Now the industries, the factories started producing on large scale. For their production, they needed raw materials as well as markets for their finished goods. Again, listen carefully. For their production, they needed raw materials like coal, like iron, like cotton. They needed raw materials, and for their prepared goods, like clothes, they needed market to sell. These reasons prompted Britain and some other European countries to search for colonies so that they can meet their need of raw materials as well as they can find markets to sell their finished goods. My dear students, one of the most important result of industrialization was colonialization. What is colonialization? We will read about colonialization in details in next chapter. And the third force, the third reason for modernization was the American and French Revolution. It gave the ideals of freedom, it gave the ideals of equality, it gave the ideals of liberty, fraternity. It influenced the people all over the world, and people started protesting against any domination, any exploitation. People started struggling for the establishment of democracy and for their freedom. And India was also deeply influenced by these revolutions. And the last one is nationalism. What is nationalism? I think I have described it in previous class. Nationalism is the feeling. Nationalism is the feeling of love, pride and loyalty for the people of their nation. Means people were willingly ready to sacrifice anything for the pride of their nation. So India was also influenced, and Indians started fighting for the freedom from Britishers in late 19th century. So my dear students, today we have read about the main reasons, main forces of changes that was responsible for modernization. And in next class we will read about modern world and India, resources of modern India to study. We will read in next class. Thank you.